What is going on, everybody? Prestige here, and today we are going to be talking a little bit about Call of Duty Advanced Warfare and the multiplayer to come with it. This is going to be a wish list of mine on things that I would personally like to see come to the multiplayer. Make sure you guys let me know your opinions down below in the comments section as well, and remember to share your support by leaving a thumbs up on this video. So let's begin. The first thing I would like to talk about is the ranking system. Personally, I would like to see an XP ranking system like we've seen in multiple Call of Duties already, where you get a kill, you earn 100 experience points, and that experience points goes towards your level progression in the game. Not something like how Halo does it, where you get one XP for every game you win. That's something that would just take a ridiculously long time to reach max rank and then eventually prestige. And that's another thing, prestiging. I would love to see that come back. Obviously, it's something that is my pastime when it comes to playing Call of Duty. I personally would like to see a change in the prestige system, something how we've talked about in previous videos, you know, where you can get more customization options or more things that are more fit to somebody that has reached a higher prestige as opposed to somebody who hasn't prestiged at all. You know, more options for somebody that has put more time and more effort into the game. So an XP ranking system, that's what I would like to see. Moving on, a new way to unlock camouflage or attachments, or camouflage and attachments for that matter. So I would like to see the kills come back, like you need to reach this certain amount of kills or get this certain amount of kills to get this attachment. So that forces you to use a weapon until you get that attachment. And then I would also like to see, you know, the camouflage come back by getting headshots, you know, 50 headshots for, you know, winter camouflage, 100 headshots for blue tiger, you know, something like that. Something that shows that you put a lot of effort into using that weapon as opposed to maybe just doing, you know, 50 lean kills. Oh, you got 50 lean kills with this weapon, so this is what you got to do. And that's another thing. I don't want to see leaning come back. I think that it's a really good thing. It works really well in Call of Duty Ghosts, but it's just something that I don't like to see in the multiplayer because it's kind of ridiculous if you think about it. Moving on, I would like to see two separate multiplayer modes, one for league play, progressive ranking, stuff like that, for people who want to go in, play hard, win, and get that position that shows that they're a hardcore player and they ground out that position to get that medal or that badge that they earned. And I would also like to see a regular multiplayer playlist similar to what Call of Duty Black Ops 2 did. This made a really good separation between the casual Call of Duty community and the hardcore esports gaming community. And I kind of see, well, okay, this is what I've seen in Call of Duty Ghosts. Both of those communities on a train heading towards each other on one track. And then, boom, they collide and Call of Duty Ghosts multiplayer happens. That's basically how I can sum it up in the best way possible. I feel like in some cases I can go against the most casual players. And I don't consider myself a casual player when it comes down to just, you know, trying to go in and play. I really like to grind out those ranks. So when I'm going up against people like that, I definitely do get a run for my money. But it also makes me a lot more frustrated. I don't know why. Maybe it's because I'm not used to playing with people on that, you know, skill level, I guess. So two different play mode, you know, playlists, MP modes, league play, regular play. You know, it doesn't have to necessarily be called league play. I just called it that in this video so you guys understand what I'm talking about. Moving over to the next thing, standard game types. You know, team deathmatch, search and destroy, domination, all those have got to come back. Those have got to be there. But I would also like to see some new game modes that maybe we haven't seen yet. You know, Call of Duty Ghosts and Infinity Ward, they introduced Reinforce recently. That game mode is freaking awesome. That is really fun. I like that game mode. If you haven't tried it yet, try it out right now. I know that it's live in the playlists. But yeah, I would personally like to see a new type of game mode or game modes that we haven't seen yet. And I would also like to see those classic team deathmatch, domination, search and destroy. Those game modes have got to be there. And I think that was one mistake that Infinity Ward made when launching Call of Duty Ghosts. Search and destroy was not there. Search and rescue, however, was, which is a really good take and a good variant on search and destroy. But search and destroy is, you know, the number one. It's got to be there. Moving on to, this is going into, you know, more advanced warfare. If the suits, you know, the mechanical suits that we can wear, play a role in the multiplayer, I would personally like to see a division in the playlists, you know, like a regular team deathmatch with regular soldiers, and then a, let's just say, a mech deathmatch with, you know, super soldiers with the suits. That's something that I would personally like to see a split in. I'm not sure how the suits are going to act. Like I said, we haven't seen much about the multiplayer yet. At all, actually. We haven't seen anything about the multiplayer yet, so I'm really excited to see what they're going to be doing with the suits, but like I've said in a previous video, maybe if they do take, you know, some sort of turn into the multiplayer, there's got to be, like, certain sections that you can, I don't know, let's say you can run up this wall because the window's two stories high. You can go to this window or this ledge because it's three stories high. Something like that. Not where you can constantly just super jump or super punch and stuff like that. It wouldn't make any sense in the Call of Duty game. Alrighty, this is getting more into the customization. More controls with killstreak customization, or have more control with that. You know, maybe have a mixture of support and assault. You know, possibly two killstreak counters. One killstreak for support, one killstreak for assault. And, you know, they'll both be stacking at the same time. You know, whatever the streak is, just think about how Call of Duty Ghost does it. They have the little bars showing how close you are. Just imagine you have a ballistic vest on your left side of the screen, and you have, or, you know, maybe they'll even be right next to each other. A ballistic vest right there, and then an attack chopper right there. So the ballistic vest will be 8, so, you know, continually counting up. Even if you die, it's always going to be counting up. But then the chopper, it's going to have its own little counter, so, you know, try to get 9 kills, and those will both be counting at the same time. So I think that would work, you know, to a point, to be able to customize any streaks that you want together. So maybe you want to run the ballistic vest and you want to use a chopper, or maybe you want to run a maniac and you want to use an oracle, you know, things like that. That would be a really cool mixture to see. And then another thing, have streaks roll. So when you do actually get your ballistic vests and you don't have the time to just throw them out there, have them roll and have them stack. So you can have two ballistic vests ready to go if you happen to get the streak again and don't throw them out there. That's something that's always a pet peeve of mine, especially if I'm doing really good in a game and I get a helicopter and I forget to call it in for some reason. Then I automatically stack another helicopter and then I only get one. That just kind of sucks, you know. I guess it's my fault for not calling it in, but I wish that those would stack, you know, something how when you pick things out of care packages, how those stack together. That would be cool. I would really like that, but I guess that kind of solves the problem for a lot of air support spam, so maybe it's not the best idea, but personally I would like to see stackable streaks again, at least in the support, you know, UAVs, stuff like that. Okay, and then the final thing that I have on this list is an in-depth customization for camouflages, emblems, clan tags, etc. I would like to see custom camos, sort of how they did the custom emblems in Black Ops 2. You know, there's a lot of people that are really... really immature when it comes to making their emblems. You know what I'm talking about, when people are making X-rated things on their weapons and stuff like that. That's just kind of, you know, childish. But if there was a control to the point where you could just customize your camouflage with maybe shapes, not, you know, suggestive shapes, you know, maybe colors, stuff like that, special designs that you might be able to morph and stuff like that, that would be cool. You know, there's no way getting around all the immature people that do customize things like that, but there's a lot of really good, you know, custom emblems that I personally seen in Call of Duty Black Ops 2, Call of Duty Black Ops, that, you know, a lot of those custom emblems were just amazing. You know, even the developers thought, holy crap, I never thought anyone would make something like this in this game. So that's just the ideas that I have for my wish list for the Advanced Warfare multiplayer. You know, a few things, of course, we've seen in previous games, but why fix it if it's broke? That's the best way to think about it in that sense. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. Do you have any wishes of your own that you would like to see in the multiplayer for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare? And if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to show your support by leaving a thumbs up. If you haven't yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button. I'm on the road to 250,000 subscribers. Gonna have a lot of awesome videos coming through E3. Gonna have a lot of updates. Gonna have some more Halo. Gonna have some Minecraft, maybe. But until next time, I am out. Peace.